A good morning to all. It's a great pleasure to have you all on this occasion of launching of this particular website of the School of Business. So I would like to start this auspicious occasion with the Institute anthem, and we'll proceed after that. Please. Thank you. It's a great honor to have all of you here on this particular auspicious occasion and a very important occasion for IIT Guwahati, where we are starting with the School of Business, which is the latest member of the IIT family. So I would like to extend my warm welcome to our chief guest, Professor T.G. Sitaram, Director of IIT Guwahati, and I would also like to extend my warm welcome to the two guests of honor, Professor Bapat, who is the member of Board of Governors of IIT Guwahati, and Professor Prahlad Ramarao, who is also another member of the Board of Governors of IIT Guwahati. They, along with them, we have with us Professor Biswanatham, who had played a very important role in shaping of this particular school, and then who have been with us right from the beginning, along with Professor Prahlad Ramarao. So with this, I would like to invite our director, sir, to launch this particular website. Now, I would like our chief guest, Professor T.G. Sitaram, to say a few words with us. In fact, I think, Professor, the school we are having today, we could see the light of the day of this particular school because of the constant support and motivation from our director. I would like our director to say a few words.
Namaste. Thank you very much. I'm very happy to see the School of Business starting its activities at IIT Guwahati. There are a large number of people who have helped us to come to this stage. Anyway, thank you everyone for being here for the launching of the website. of the School of Business. Professor Bapat, Professor Ramarao, Professor Vishwanatham, Professor Gupta, and all my distinguished colleagues, both from IIT Guwahati as well as IIM Ahmedabad, and friends, students, and staff of IIT Guwahati. It's really a great moment for us because this is the fifth school we are starting. And two of them were actually centers earlier, Center for Energy, which was converted to School of Energy Sciences and Engineering. And then we have started already the two other schools, School of Health Science and Technology, School of Data Science and Artificial Intelligence. And we had a center for rural technology, which was converted to School of Agro and Rural Technology. So this is the last one. That is we are very, very happy that today we have assembled to launch the School of Business website. I'm very happy to tell you also the School of Business, the curriculum for MBA, as well as the minor program for all our BTech has already been approved by the Senate. And now that is going to the Board of Governors on 28th of this month. So, and also we are jointly advertising this program with other IITs. So there is a through CAT examination, we are going to admit students for MBA program. And also we provide opportunity for our all the undergraduate students, close to about 1,000 undergraduate students, a minor program in business development, marketing, finance, HR, so that they could be a tomorrow an entrepreneur or a startup company owners, so that they no more the job seekers, they will be job creators. And I would like to remember the way we started in 2019 with Professor Vishwanatham and Professor Ramarao helping us and guiding us in the beginning. And we had several meetings. And we took almost 1.5 years. And then finally, we identified Professor Boeing Singh from civil engineering to lead. And he has done really hard work and brought everything to this stage. So now we have to hire faculty. That is also on the process. We're going to start our faculty hiring. I request particularly the experts who are here can also suggest some good resume or good people who are experts in this area to move to IIT Guwahati. So we are going to start our, so I'm very happy that Professor Anil Gupta is also joining. And he has really, Professor Anil Gupta from IIM Ahmedabad had really brought large number of professors from IIM to guide us and help us. We had series of discussions with him. And he even helped in framing the curriculum, okay, and also the process. Professor Bapat is always there for us to help in our board. And through his ideas, we started this Center for Indian Knowledge System at IIT Guwahati. So thank you, Professor Bapat. Thank you, Professor Ramarao. Thank you, Vishwanatham. Thank you, Professor Anil Gupta ji. And I'm very happy to see, at least, you know, it has culminated into a new school. And we are hoping that there will be a large number of people who also show interest and join, very similar to our data science and artificial intelligence program. See, we have started a BTech in data science and artificial intelligence program, where there was a lot of traction. The top JEE rankers, JEE advanced rankers have chosen IIT Guwahati in that program. So very similar to this, I think we are expecting for the School of Business. And this is going to bring a lot of change because we do have an engineering, science, and design departments, along with humanities. Our humanities group is also very large, and a couple of faculty from humanities are involved in the School of Business as well. So I think this multidisciplinary approach with the business development and entrepreneurship and startups would give our students a lot of opportunities. And I wish that this would be a very successful program. With these few remarks, I'm very happy today to launch this website. We just did that, and website has also come up very well. Congratulations to the people who have developed the website. It's very colorful, and it looks complete in all respects. So if you go through that, you know, there are three programs they're planning to start from July. One is the minor program for all our BTech, BDesign students, then MBA program, and the PhD program. The PhD program now needs a little bit of processing in the institute through the Senate and other things. We're going to do that in January, February. So the March will start the admission. So July will be the one where we will start all the three programs and the business school of business. So with this brief information, again, thank everyone who have joined here on this platform for launching this website. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai.
Thank you, sir. I think in a very short time, I think you have set light on how the school has progressed from being a very conceptual idea to an entity right now. With this, I would like to ask Professor Prahlada Ramarao, a member, Board of Governors, IIT Guwahati, say a few words to the gathering.
Good morning to all of you. Yeah. And am I audible, boy? Okay. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
First is I would like to congratulate IIT Guwahati, all the staff members and others who have made this happen at a very fast pace. And we also thank Professor Varadara for the inputs given by various experts, especially from Professor Vishwanatham, who is like a mentor for this business education. So I am very happy, and I have only 2-3 points to share on this very auspicious occasion, because this is a milestone, and I am sure Boeing Singh will take it forward with all the enthusiasm and focus. And what I agree with Professor Sitaram, he said it is you have got a unique opportunity with the engineering subjects, science subjects, humanities. With this, you are able to add to that the business and management. So I would like to say include health science also. It's a new branch. Health science also is your fourth. So you are having four basic streams: engineering, science, humanities, and health. Above that, you have a management and business. So it's a very nice place. Very uniquely, you are configured and you are positioned to this. This is number one point. Second point is, see, as we all discussed, it's a unique, we want to make this a unique center, school, unique school. And uniqueness comes from, you know, we have been talking about, the Northeast itself is a mini India. So India is a big country, and if you want to succeed in business and management, you require all the skill, all the learning, new techniques, new strategies, you have to do something entirely uniquely you have to do. So this taken as a Northeast model, and then see how it can be all pan-India, then finally a global school. This is what you have to see. This is one uniqueness we have to ensure that it will happen. Second is, the involvement of industry, successful sort of a business champions should be your basic. You have to include them more and more. You may have to share success stories like maybe Vinod Vikram Sarabhai, Dr. Kalam, Satish Dhawan, even Narendra Modi, Kurian. You should see how they have become leaders and what made them succeed in this country, which is a very, very different country when compared to other nations in the world. We are a highly diverse country with a conglomeration of whatever you can think is here in India. So to run a business successfully is very tough. So I want you to see how you can configure this school to handle such a big challenge. Probably the challenge India faces, many countries may not face, because you are the most diverse in the world. So that point you please note down and see how you can configure. Then the business is also, we have the strategy and sustainability. when you say business, it's not simply running a company. It is a strategy and sustainability over a long period. Then it should be management science driven. It is a management science and sort of a principles, management principles driven. Then it's also ethics driven. See, we should be famous for ethics driven business education. And we should also say how we are socially responsible as a school. Socially responsible. These are the, like, you know, four pillars of business. It's not simply business. It's much more than business. I want to also suggest to Boeing, instead of just calling school a business, you think something which will represent what I am sharing with you, something name you think, instead of just school of business, can we make it something which is unique, instead of, because there are a number of schools of business. I suggest you think Boeing and then consult your colleagues and see how you can give a more, I will say, it's a more representative title. I want you to give just a simple school of business. And then also I want you to see how do you plan for the future. See, don't plan for what is existing. Next 10 years, next 20 years, how you should shape our young people, school in the sense, what direction we have to plan, and what is the novelty we have to bring, how do you bring out new strategies, new learning methods, and new business science. For example, today's business may just become outdated in another 10 years. The business model we are talking today may not be the business model after 10 years. You have seen how Elon Musk has changed the space business and automobile business. It's a watershed moment. The space business and automobile business had undergone such a big change. We don't know what next will happen. Healthcare also, I feel, it will change a big way. So business people should be, your school should be planning ahead how do you handle new challenges. These are my thoughts I thought I will share with all of you. I again congratulate IIT Guwahati and all its members for such a momentous occasion, and you will make a difference. I wish you all the best. Thank you very much for giving me a chance to share my views. Thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you, Professor Ramarao, I think, for giving the guidance on how to take the school forward. The points which were being identified by you and shared with us are very, very relevant, and that will be given due consideration, and we will try to work out on that. Thank you, sir, again, once again for that. Now, I'd like to ask our guest of honor, Professor Bharat Raj B. Bapat, member, Board of Governor, IIT Guwahati, to say a few words to the gathering. Please, sir.
Namaste, everyone. I feel privileged to be invited here, and I also join to congratulate Professor Sitaram and the whole team from IIT Guwahati for the all-round achievements which have been happening at IIT Guwahati. First is, of course, the strides on technology side, but I am seeing an all-round growth. As was mentioned in the beginning, it includes a school of health sciences. Already we have school of design. Now we have a school of rural technology and agriculture, and not to be missed, also the center for Indian knowledge systems. So I'm happy that all round progress of students and also contribution to the society would be possible through all these initiatives. Now the very important addition is going to happen in the form of School of Business. For any organization or educational institution, it is very important how much impact on society, on corporate world, on policy making can be made by the institution. And I'm sure with the addition of School of Business, that impact is going to increase by multifold. We already have excellent people in technology. But if they become leaders, I'm sure their impact will increase, and School of Business would be an important step in shaping that leadership, not only in corporate world, It could be in any field of governance, management, non-profit organizations, or even as a policymakers. So I'm sure this is going to be a great stride in the right direction. And this is also a right time. You would have heard of several news of Indians taking over as CEOs of global multinationals. So Indian leadership is being increasingly accepted in the corporate world. As Professor just now mentioned, our leadership as policymakers is already making a significant impact. And world over, people are increasingly looking at Indian style of management. Initially, it was understood that management science or management faculty is essentially evolved in USA, and it's more an American concept. Later on, in 90s, Japanese management practices became in thing, and a lot of discussion happened about Japanese management practices. But post 2015, it is the Indian management practices which are getting attracted, and it is not just practices, it is also the Indian theories of management. Just to give one example, all of we are aware that Bhagavad Gita talks about karmanneva dhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana ma karma phala heturbhu mate sangosta karmani. So as you focus, don't just focus on goals, rather focus on means. Results would automatically come if we use appropriate means. If we focus our attention on the right path, results are bound to come. This is an ethical way, and this is also going to be a successful way. Because if one looks at results continuously, sometimes one can be successful. But if somebody fails, then one every chance that one goes into a wrong direction. Whereas Karma Yoga teaches us, keeps us on the right path in success and also in failures. And that is where Indian theory of management is being increasingly realized. I just gave you an example of HR, but it's equally true in marketing, finance, operations, and all domains of management. And I'm sure that the School of Business, which is coming up, I'm happy to note that in the first year itself, it is going to offer BTech minor, MBA, as well as PhD. But just going beyond offering programs, I'm sure it would also be a major contributor to the management theory. Because being in a privileged institution like IIT, I think that's our core job. Apart from doing our routine activities, it should be a long-term impact. And I'm sure our School of Business would definitely go in the right direction, and that too at a very high pace. With this, I stop. Once again, all the best wishes to the whole team of IIT Guwahati, and particularly to the upcoming School of Business. Namaste, dhanyawad.
Thank you, Professor Bapat, for the encouraging word, and then asking us to fall back on the traditional knowledge and all those things. This is a very important thing, and in the global environment, the Indians are making a good business icons nowadays. Some of the big companies are being run by Indians only, and that shows that the Indian ethics and Indian philosophy it's much more time tested, and it has a big way to go in the coming years. So along with this, I think since we have with us Professor Vishwanatham, who has been with us right from the beginning, if it is okay with Professor Vishwanatham, I think we'd like to have a few words from you. The gathering would like to hear a few words from your side. Is that okay, sir?
Thank you. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to say a few words. I've been, if you look at my life, I was at Indian Institute of Science as an engineer, electrical engineer. But afterwards, I went to School of Business in Singapore. And afterwards, I was heading a global logistics center with ISB and so on. So in my life, I went through several of these changes, like from engineering to management and so on. So I always suggest instead of the framework, management framework becomes very important. And recently, I've been working on agriculture as well as hospital ecosystems and so on in healthcare. So these becomes, I am applying both engineering and management science techniques to have, for example, telemedicine, or to have agriculture platforms, mandis, and so on and all that. So management for social good, it becomes very, very important, as the previous speakers have suggested, for healthcare, for agriculture and all that. So the management school should also combine with or collaborate with other agriculture institutions, AI and ML algorithm schools and others, to basically have a new discipline, which is the management and engineering for social good in this. And I wish this school a great success, and I was happy to be involved, associated with this with this school. So I think beyond this, all I can say is to pray God that this school should become one of the top schools in the world. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir, I think, for your blessing. We hope, I think, we will be able to make those strides, and then we will be able to climb later, and then achieve more, bring more laurels to the institute in the coming years. So with this, I think I would like to ask Professor Nachiketa Tripathi to deliver the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Professor Bhim Singh, our Honorable Director, Professor T.G. Sitaram, members of Board of Governors, Padma Shri Professor Rama Rao, Professor Bapat, and Professor Vishnathan and Professor Gupta, my colleagues, and other members of IIT Guwahati fraternity, those who have joined online. I would like to thank all of you for sparing time from your busy schedule to grace this occasion. And I would like to mention here that though it is a small step toward in the direction of big journey, but as they say that every journey starts with a first step. So this is the first step towards that journey, which we have to cover in the due course of time. And whatever you see today in terms of our website, this is a team effort. And everything has been achieved under the able guidance of our director. Whenever we met him, his message was crisp and clear. And underlying message, which he never said, was make it happen. And that is the most motivating factor, which gave us some kind of input and some kind of excitement to work and make it happen. And very soon, in the month of January, we will start our admission process. And this is not just about opening the business school. We will not stop there. Rather, it is to, as Professor Vishnathan has mentioned, it is not just about opening the school, rather creating some kind of brand value for us, that in the coming few years, we should be able to create brand value for our school, so we can attract good faculty, good students, and we can create some kind of valuation to our system. So with these words, I would like to thank all of you for sparing time and grace these occasions. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.